As per Newton's second law, if a force F is applied to an object, it accelerates. If the object acceleration is because of the Earth's gravitational force, then that is known as acceleration due to gravity and represented by G. The value of G at the Earth's surface is 9.8 meters per second square, and it varies as we go above or below the Earth's surface. Stay with me and know what is the meaning of acceleration due to gravity, how to find its value at the Earth's surface, and see how it varies with height, depth, and rotation of the Earth. If you drop a ball from the roof of a building, it moves toward the Earth because of a pulling force. This pulling force by the Earth is known as gravitational force. This gravitational force creates an acceleration in object motion, and that acceleration is known as acceleration due to gravity. Gravity is pulling or attraction force because of mass of an object. It is a weak force. But since Earth has a large mass, the force of gravity because of its mass is noticeable. This force of gravity on an object near the Earth's surface is given by the formula F equal to gmm by r square, where the g is universal gravitational constant. Capital M is the mass of the Earth, r is the radius of Earth, and the small m is the mass of an object. Here, from the second law of Newton, or Newton's second law, F equal to ma, where m is the mass of an object and a is the acceleration. Now, if we equate these two equations, we'll get the value of acceleration a equal to gm by r square. And this acceleration is due to gravity and represented by z. So now if you put the value of these parameters, you will get the value of g. It's equal to 9.81 meter per second square. So this acceleration in object motion because of Earth gravitational force is known as acceleration due to gravity. And this is independent of object mass, shape, and size. It means if we drop two or three different objects from the same height, they will accelerate with the same acceleration. And this results in object reaching the ground at the same time. This is true only when objects are in free fall. Free fall means objects are under gravity only, and no other force is acting on those, not even the air resistance. So when we told that these three objects will fall and reach to the ground at the same time, we assume that there is no air or there is no air resistance. It means there is only force of gravity, and it's equivalent to that this fall is under vacuum. Okay. So only in that case, all these three objects will reach to the ground at the same time. To check what is free fall and how the equations of motions are applicable in that, check out our next video on free fall. So we got the value of acceleration due to gravity is equal to 9.81 meter per second square. Now, what is the meaning of this acceleration in respect of the falling bodies from this high story building? To understand that, let's take the velocity at this different instant of time. So at time t is equal to 0, the initial velocity is 0, object is at rest, and we dropping it. So if we check the speed or velocity of that object after 1 second, it will be 9.8 meter per second. What about 2 seconds? After 2 seconds, the speed will be, or velocity will be 19.6 meter per second. So here you see from 0 to 1 second it increased by 9.8 meters per second. In another second it's increased another 9.8. So 9.8 plus 9.8 is 19.6 meters per second. I think now you can predict what will be the speed of that object after 3 seconds. And you are right, it's 29.4. Now let's see some facts about Z, the acceleration due to gravity. As we move above the Earth's surface, the G value reduces. At any height h above the ground, the value of G can be given by this formula. Here a small r is the distance of this point from the center of the Earth. Okay? So you can see that r equal to r plus h, which is greater than capital R or radius of the Earth. So the g dash value is less than the g, the original value of g, which is gm by capital R square, as we saw in our previous slides. So this equation can be rewritten in different forms like that. In a special case, when your height above the ground is very less as compared to R, then this formula can be written in this way. The derivation of these formulas will not cover in this session, but you can check our another videos on gravitational, in that we will cover it. Now similarly, if we go below the Earth's surface, how the value of G changes? Here you see the diagram. So in this case also, as we move below the Earth's surface, the value of G reduces. And at any depth h below the ground, the value of g can be given by the formula g dash by g m dash here divided by small r square. Remember, here the small r is the distance of the point where we are trying to get the value of g. And in this case, especially m dash is not the mass of the Earth, but it is a mass of the Earth inner of radius r only. If you see this, this is the inner sphere of radius r, and this m dash is the mass of that inner sphere of the Earth of radius r. G basically is equal to gm by r square, right? If we use these two equations, we will reach to this equation. When we derive these equations, we assume that the Earth is a uniform sphere with the uniform density. Okay, so density of Earth is uniform. And again, as r, small r is nothing but r minus h, you can rewrite the same equation in another form. Okay. Now there is one more factor which affects the value of g, that is the rotation of the Earth. Here, because of the rotation of the Earth, every object which is on Earth's surface will feel a centrifugal force which is outside. Here, the small r is the radius in which the object at the surface is rotating in a circle, and this is equivalent to capital R cos theta. Capital R is the radius of the Earth, and this is also theta, right? So R cos theta is a small r. And the value of g dash is equal to g minus r small r omega square cos theta. This equation can be rewritten in the form of radius of the Earth r, and at equator where theta is equal to 0, if you see this theta, if object is at equator, this theta value is 0, and in this case the g dash is equal to g minus r omega square, and this is the minimum value at the Earth's surface for gravitational acceleration, and this is the maximum reduction in it, which is equal to r omega square. At poles, theta is 90 degrees. Poles are here, right? These are poles. So here angle theta is basically 90 degrees. So in that case, cos 90 is 0, so g dash becomes g. So here, the at poles, the value of g is maximum. Okay, because there is no reduction in the value of G because of the centrifugal force which is exist at all other places except the poles. Okay. Now even this maximum reduction in the G, which is at equators, okay, is not very big, is very very small, and that is because the value of omega for earth rotation is very small. Okay, so that is the reason this value is small, and overall reduction in G is very very small, right? And again I will repeat the derivation of all these values of G or variation of value of G we'll be doing in another video, which will be we will be going to make on gravitational chapter. Now it is a time for three conceptual questions. Try these questions and put your comments and answers in comment box. Answers to these questions you can find in description box below here. I hope you would have enjoyed this session. And if you think you have learned something new today, then please click like button and subscribe us for similar type of videos. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.